Good morning, everybody. This is the Stonehouse Church in Kilsyth, broadcasting this morning from Wishaw, North Lanarkshire, where I live with my husband David Whiteman. And we are bringing you this morning our family service, which happens the first Sunday of every month. And today we have put together some fun items. David is going to do the children's story along with myself, and David will bring us today's word from the Bible. And today's verses is based on, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." Jeremiah 29 verses 11. And as we go through this pandemic, we all have to set plans. So we're FaceTiming our family and friends. Our kids are FaceTiming all their friends at school. They're getting online training from their teachers. A whole lot of things are all happening. The church have got Zoom quiz nights set up. We've got services set up. And we thank you for welcoming us into your home.
Giving us new
So today we have got some songs, we've got some kids songs, so we're going to go to Bob and he is going to take it away with Be Bold, Be Strong, and we're hopefully going to have some of the kids doing the actions. So fingers crossed, take it away Bob.
Well thanks Helen. Well kids, I'm going to sing a song now for you. It's called Be Bold, Be Strong. We'll sing it through twice. Join in with us, sing and dance. Are you ready? Let's go. Here we go.
Be bold, be strong, for the Lord your God is with you. Be bold, be strong, for the Lord your God is with you.
And he keeps us from any harm. And as we go through this tough time that we're all experiencing, God is always with us. No matter what the circumstances in your life, God will be with you. And if you need any help or prayer, the Storehouse Church is always there to help. And we have people that are dedicated to pray. We've got people that you can talk to. We're also giving out, we're working in partnership with Food Angels just now, who are handing out meals to people in the local area, Inclesize, out to Twecker, Queensburn, Banton, Inclesize, and we're thankful for these people that are giving up their time to work with the Storehouse to put out these lovely meals that they're putting out. So we would just like to thank, we're going to go over to Bob again, and he's going to play another couple of songs. So over to you, Bob. We'll speak to you soon. Bye.
Thanks again, Helen. We're going to sing another song for the kids now. This one's called This Little Light of Mine. You'll know the song, and there's three verses to it. The first one's This Little Light of Mine. The second one's Hide It Under a Bushel. And the third one's Don't Let Satan Blow It Out. And we'll sing the first verse again at the very end. So are you ready? Let's sing. Here we go.
Hide it under a bushel, no, I'm gonna let it shine.
you. Thanks for listening. Now it's back to you, Helen.
Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God, and He holds us in His hand. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God, and He holds us in His hand. He's higher than a skyscraper and deeper than a submarine. He's wider than the universe and beyond my wildest dreams. And He's known me and He's loved me since before the world began. A wonderful to be a part of God's amazing plan. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God, and He holds us.
Singing and dancing to that one.
Now we're over to David, who's going to bring the kids' story. So are you ready, kids? Can I hear a yes from you all? Yes! Let's get started. David's got a fabulous story today, and I've been asked to help with the props. So fingers crossed it'll all work out. So let's get going.
Well now, I've been tasked with preparing for the holiday because I'm supposed to have planned this. But I'm not very good at it. So all I think I need to do for my holiday is pack my swimming trunks and some beach towels, a couple of beach towels, pack up swimming trunks, and that's fine. I think that's perfect. But I'm sure Helen's got other things that she needs. She probably needs a swimming costume or something. So I better see if she's there and find out what she's wanting in the case. Helen, are you there?
Yes!
Right, I've packed my stuff. I've packed my stuff. Have you got stuff that you want to go in?
David, what have you got in this case?
What have I got in the case? Well, let's see, what have I got in the case? I've got a couple of towels, a couple of beach towels, pair of swimming shorts, and that's me. I'm fine.
David!
What?
If you think we're going on holiday with two beach towels and your swimming trunks.
I think that's alright. I'm fine for the beach, fine for the pool. What more do I need?
I think you need to plan. You know, God has a plan for us. He knows a plan for every single one of us. And He plans our lives out for us, even before we know about it. He knows what the plans we have, He has for us, and what we have to do. And when we go through difficult situations like the pandemic just now and the coronavirus, God has a plan that he'll see us through.
All right, uh-huh. Right, so let me think now. If I'm going on holiday, what do I need to do? I need to get a ticket, don't I? I need to buy a flight and buy a hotel and things.
Well, you booked the ticket, David, so the holiday...
Wait a minute. Yes, I did book the holiday. Yes, aye.
I had to pay
for it as well. So, yeah, I think... Oh, look, here's some tickets. Flying from Glasgow to Gran Canaria. Seven nights, half board, fancy hotel. I must have done really well.
Let's just hope our flights are flying.
So tickets, there we go. And if we're going a plane, because we need to fly to Gran Canaria, it's a bit far to drive, get a bit wet. We need a passport, don't we? Because we need to go to the airport, we need a passport.
Yes.
So let's see, I've got some passports in here, I hope. Oh yes, look, passports. Let's see, oh, there we go. Dodgy picture of me. Let's see. Oh, even dodgier picture of Helen. So
doesn't even look like me.
No, I know. It's passports in the case. But you know why? Where else we need a passport for, Helen?
Where?
We need a passport to get into heaven. Did you know that?
I don't think you need a passport to get into heaven, David.
Oh, you do need a passport to get into heaven. And the passport...
No.
The passport that you need is the love of the Lord Jesus in your heart.
And that, I do believe, David.
Yes, you need to know Jesus as your personal saviour.
Yes.
And that's the passport that you need to get into heaven. So we're all right, we've got our passports, we've got our tickets, we need some money. Because you like to spend money, don't you?
Oh, yes.
You like to spend money, so...
I definitely do. And especially, you definitely always need money, David. No matter what we do, we need money.
Look at that. Purse with lots of euros in it, so we're all right there.
That's not going to get me shoes, David.
Wait a minute. Oh, look. That's obviously my purse for my coins, because I'm only allowed coins.
That's my purse.
That's your purse, aye.
I've got paper notes.
It's all right for some. So it is. So there we go. Money. Tickets, passports, what else do we need when we go away?
What about my sunglasses?
Have you got my sunglasses on, David?
Oh,
look, there's sunglasses there. Nice pair of sunglasses. I remember when you got them.
Ralph Lauren ones. I remember you
getting them in the airport on the way out to the last holiday.
I hope everybody likes them.
And your sister liked them because she pinched them half the holiday.
Probably did, because that's just harsh.
Right, so sunglasses to protect your eyes, just like Jesus protects you.
He does indeed.
Because he knows the plans that he has for you.
Yes.
What else do we need? Well, when we go to the sun, it's always warm and sticky.
Yes.
So we need to go into the shower. And there we've got some nice hand soap. So we're always having a wash there. Because you know what the Bible says?
You've got to have a pure heart.
And clean hands.
And God always protects us. So, when we have a pure heart and clean hands, God will always look after us. Because he is a wonderful person who will look after us. No matter what we do, God protects us in everything we do.
Yeah. Another thing that gives you protection, suntan lotion.
Yes.
Because it stops the sun rays burning your skin. So we better put some of that in as well.
Yeah.
So lots of protection, just like Jesus' blood protects us from the bad things that happen in the world.
Yes.
So what else do we need? I know.
Communication.
Communication, that's it. Communication. So we need to take a phone.
But, David... When you're abroad, you need a special adapter.
You need a special adapter?
We do.
Oh, wait a minute. Special adapter, there we go, that's right, because it's got a different plug socket in Gran Canaria, hasn't it?
Yeah.
So.
But God adapts our lives No matter how bad our lives are and how good our lives is, God shapes ourselves.
Uh-huh.
And he adapts us into being someone who's loving and caring. And all our storehouse kids are very caring. And the next family service, they are going to be doing different things. But that's the secret at the moment, David.
Yes, uh-huh. So as I say, we'd better put your phone in, because you like to phone home and speak to your mum and dad.
Yes. But also, David, because all the storehouse services are online, we can use our iPads and we can use our phone and we can zoom into our storehouse quizzes.
Yep.
We can zoom into our church services.
Uh-huh.
We can zoom into the communion services.
Yep, the prayer meeting.
All the different things we are putting online at the moment.
Uh-huh.
So the church has had to change all the plans, and all the leadership team have had to put a whole different plan into place.
Yeah, that's right.
So to get us through this horrible time.
Yes. Uh-huh. So the other thing that we really need to pack.
No, David.
We need to pack the Bible.
No,
what,
David.
What have I forgotten now?
You forgot we've got to take pictures for Bob and Sheena.
Picture? Oh, aye, there's a camera there.
Because Bob and Sheena are doing their devotionals at the moment.
Aye.
And Bob likes his scenery.
Aye.
So we better take some pictures of Gran Canaria to bring back to him.
Yep, that's right. He's probably got plenty anyway, because he was there last year with us.
And?
We need the Bible in, don't
no.
we? No. What else? You know what we haven't got in?
Shoes. Just wait a wee minute.
Shoes. Helen hasn't got her shoes in. She always needs to take a pair of shoes with her, because she goes a wee walk along the seafront, where we can see God's handiwork in his creation. We see the sea, and we see the palm trees, and we see everything. But shall I won't allow her to take one pair of shoes with her.
Shoes?
One pair of shoes, that's right. One pair of shoes. I was just saying, because we like to go a wee walk along the seafront and admire God's handiwork in the sea.
Yes.
And the palm trees and things. But she only takes what? She's only allowed one pair of shoes in on the way out. She usually has seven on the way back.
David, you're letting away my secrets again.
I thought everybody knew about your shoes.
Shoes
and your handbags.
Shoes and handbags, that's just my thing.
Aye, and I have to plan to pay for them all.
Would anyway, I do a thing like that?
Anyway, we really do need to pack this.
We do.
We need to pack
the Bible. Why do we have to pack our Bible?
Because when we're away,
David, we pack other books.
Yeah, but when we're away, it gives us time to sit down and relax a wee bit. And when we can relax a wee bit instead of running about daft working and running after everybody,
that's true.
We can sit down and relax, and we can get a chance to read God's Word. Because when we read God's Word and we pray, that's when he really does speak to us.
That's right, David.
And that's where we learn what he wants to do for us. Where he shows us his plans for us. The plans to make us prosperous and to keep us good.
Yeah.
And protect us from all the harm that's going on in the world.
Yeah.
So
do you think we've got everything now, David, in our case? Can we shut the case up?
Well, we can shut this case up and you can pack your own case. Because you've probably lots of other
David
things that you want
and
to pack.
Plans just don't go.
God and plans does go.
Exactly, David. So that's the end of the kids' story today. Hope that you got something out of it. So what did we say? God is a wonderful person who has plans for each and every one of us, who protects us, who's a healer, who's a loving father. And that he is so, so wonderful for us all. And it's someone that we would ask you to reach out and get saved through his loving word and through this Bible, who has got many stories. And we just want to help you get through. If you need anything, please do not hesitate to contact us. Thanks very much. Thank you, David.
Well, I hope the kids enjoyed their wee talk there, and packing the case and preparing, planning. Planning's a great thing. So let's just read Jeremiah 29:11 again. You'll be fed up here in this verse. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." The future is something that none of us know anymore. 8 weeks ago, we thought we knew what was going to happen. We thought we had all these plans to go on holiday, which we've cancelled now, had to cancel because we're not allowed to travel. Plans to move house, plans to get a new car, plans to go to the beach, plans to have a party, to celebrate a birthday, and none of that's been able to happen. And it's all very well, but we miss these things. We miss doing these things. God, on the other hand, knew exactly what was going to happen because it's all been in his plan. He's planned for the churches to be shut so that more people than ever attend can view online services. People like me and so many others sitting, speaking into a camera about their love for the Lord Jesus Christ. It's so encouraging that there are so many different people viewing, and I want to thank you for viewing this. You know, God's plan is something that he reveals to us as we learn about him. His plan is something that he reveals to us as we learn from his word, as we learn from speaking to him in prayer, and as we learn from him from being in his presence. He reveals his plans to us. He helps us on our way. I know God has revealed his plan for my life several times. Helen's going to kill me, but late one evening before we were married, I had a word from the Lord to get up and read a specific piece of scripture, and that was the piece of scripture that convinced me to marry my wife. So God has a plan. He speaks to us every time we're close to him, and that's where I hope we are all going to be, is close to God, close to Jesus, hearing their plans and hearing what they have for us. We'd planned to be away on holiday, but God had better plans for us, plans to be able to do this. So we want to pray for you. We want to reassure you that God's plan is the best plan for your life. So if you've got any concerns or any questions, please do contact us at the Storehouse Church, and we will be able to hopefully answer your questions and reassure you about the plans that God has for each one of us. The one thing that I want to say is that God wants to root us in his love. He wants us to be bound up in his love. And I heard a story not so long ago about palm trees. And palm trees were something that we, Helen and I, were going to be looking at when we were away on holiday, because we're going to somewhere warm and posh. And the story I heard about the palm trees was that in the storms of life, in the storms that occur round about them, that's when they grow stronger and stronger. Because when the winds attack the palm trees, their roots grow and they bind together the soil round about them. And even though the winds are blowing at 100 miles an hour or more, their root system stays immobile. It doesn't move. And that's what happens when we accept Jesus when we accept God into our lives. Our roots are bound up in Him, the rock which cannot move. So we want to say thank you. Thank you for listening to us. Thank you for viewing this. And we look forward to be able to see you sometime very soon, once lockdown's over, at any of the services at the church. But before we go, let's take a moment to pray. Father God, thank you that you have plans for our lives. Thank you that you know what they are. And thank you that you reveal them to us at the right time in our lives. So Lord, we just want to say, show us what you would have us do. Help us to be better people in you, and help us to do what you want us to do, so that your kingdom may be glorified. In Jesus' precious name, Amen. Thank you very much for listening.
Thanks, David, for that challenging word. Yes, as we said at the start, Jeremiah 29 verse 11, for I know the plans I have for you. God has a plan for every one of us. And I just want to play out the Crosswalks singing, I know the plans for you. Thanks for watching. 4 weeks from now, there'll be another family service. And we have got some special things happening. We're going to be Zooming some kids. We've got filmed. And lots of special things happening. So see you in 4 weeks, kids. And please remember to send in your video clips and your pictures. That's your challenge. You know what to do. You've got your package through your post. And fingers crossed it'll all work out. So speak to you all soon. And here's the Crosswalks singing, I know the plans I have for you. Thank you. And thanks everybody for watching. Thank you.
Sometimes I feel so small and wonder what God wants from me. What will I be? I listen for His call and try to wait so patiently, though I may not see.
Again and again, I know the plans I have for you, I know exactly. trust in me.